How's it going, Shy?
Oh, okay. We all know, if you've been listening to me for a while, either on this podcast or in real life, you know that I have some hippy-dippy moments, usually pertaining to astrology.
Okay.
And so you know that I am always here to point out when Mercury is in retrograde.
And we appreciate it.
Good, because it is in retrograde right now. It just started a couple of days ago, although you may have felt a little off for the past week. I definitely have felt off. Earlier this week, I turned to my roommate and I said, "Hey, does everything feel terrible?" Like, and he's like, "I mean, yeah, but did you mean something specific?" And I meant, no, like the air right now, everything that's happening right now and for the past week has been horrible in a way that I can't just go, "Well, that's bad," and keep it moving. Like it's an overcoming feeling of dread, just dread and dismay and miscommunication and all kinds of things. And it just all like earlier this week at night, I was just like, I feel horrible. Like, I feel like it's all on the precipice of falling apart. And then I went to bed and just, you know, went to work the next day. So
that's all you're dealing with?
Yeah, that's all. Just that. Just the world feeling like it's ending. And then there's just been even more news that I'm like, oh boy, oh boy.
Yeah, I'm always like, like I said, I've tried to understand a lot more of this stuff as we've worked together. And like the thing that like I feel like there is half of this idea that is scheduled, but there's also like a feeling like it's also a surprise. That's what I've never understood. Like, I feel like people would be like, oh, this, like if I asked you when does Mercury retrograde, you would be able to tell me, oh, it happens these times.
Yeah.
And yet also every time Mercury retrogrades, everybody's like, oh, I didn't see that coming. Like, I don't know how it does that.
I see it coming. I do see it coming. What I don't do now is mention when I see it coming because nobody wants to hear it. And I get that. What I do is, just for a recap, for those who are listening and are like, what is this bitch talking about? There's a time, 3, maybe 4 times a year for like 3 weeks at a time where the planet Mercury looks like it's moving backwards. And I compare it to when 2 trains leave a train station at the same time, but they're not going the exact same speed, or one speeds up, the other one looks like it's moving backwards when you're looking out of the window. It's not. It's moving in the same direction, just not as fast. And because of that, it looks like it's as you pull away, it looks like it's falling behind.
Yeah, that's trippy. Okay.
And so but you know what I'm talking about,
yeah,
right? Yeah. So that's what the planet Mercury, it looks like it's moving backwards. It's not. It's just moving slower than the other planets. And Mercury, I believe, is a planet that's kind of in charge of communication. So that means that plans that you make, conversations that you have, they all kind of go awry. And you just have to be very patient when you know that this is happening. That's basically what I notice, that things kind of go a little haywire. It also kind of controls like electronics and things and contracts. So don't buy any new electronics, or else something's gonna, like, there'll be something wrong with it, and then you got to go through the whole rigmarole of returning it and all that kind of shit. Like, so
just a minor thing like that. That's
it. Yeah, just minor things like that. But or a car or a huge contract, you know, things like this. But so I just know, oh, I need to be patient because things are going to be very confusing. And it also kind of forces everyone, hopefully, to slow down and double check their work and make sure they're not just racing forward. So it's kind of like a reboot. It's kind of like you're rebooting your personal hard drive a bit and just like, okay, let me slow down and make sure I got everything I need.
Right.
It's a moment of that. And so it's like when you finally restart your computer three times a year, that's what Mercury retrograde is. That's what that is, basically.
Okay.
So I knew that Mercury would be in retrograde. I mean, I have the dates on a post-it on my work monitor. Like, I'm not playing. So when something goes wrong in the office, I just look at that post-it and I'm like, okay, all right, I see. But yeah, so I already knew that. But I mean, like, on top of just that, I just felt like, I mean, I think it's safe to say that it feels like in America, the world is falling apart.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it feels like it's safe to say that that's how it feels. Like between the whole Supreme Court and Roe v. Wade to now we're out of shortages on baby formula and also paper towels also is something that I have noticed. The prices of things, like we're running low on stuff and we're just getting this news that like companies are taking advantage of, you know, these COVIDian times to just like raise prices and make people go, well, I mean, we have to pay it or else how else will we get the stuff? And then they don't even have the stuff. Like, it's just, everything just feels wild.
Yeah, it's off.
Yeah, everything feels off. And I don't know if I can put all that on Mercury. It's not that big of a planet. It may not want to take on the weight of Earth or whatever, but yeah.
Yeah, I noticed the towel thing very, very oddly. I bought a pizza for the family a while back. Mm-hmm. And you know, every kid has like a slice. I have a slice and Gabby has a slice. So I usually just use paper towels. Mm-hmm. You know, like pizza, as long as you don't got like a lot of toppings on it, it's a relatively like self-contained food. There's no like debris outside of a few crumbs.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So I was like, yeah, I'll put it on towels. And Gabby like went nuts. She's like, Gas, what are you doing? Don't waste the towels. Use the paper plates.
Okay.
And I said, honey, they're both disposable. I felt like I was using the more affordable option and you could clean the table after. She mm-hmm. said, no, the paper plates are way cheaper than the paper towels.
Mm.
I was like, that's insane. They're both paper. I was like, I understand. I agree with the logic. I'm just telling you what I see at the store.
Yeah, I went to a Target last week and they had no paper towels. And not like one of these bullshit New York City Targets that only have like three of everything.
Yeah.
Three boxes of trash bags, three, you know, like the little ones that they stick on a corner and they're like, New York has Target now. And it's like, but at what cost? I'm talking about the one that's like at Barclay Center that's the size of a normal suburban
Target. Oh, yeah.
No paper towels.
Yeah, it's real.
All. And running low on toilet paper.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, this is a throwback. And it wasn't like people were walking around with carts of it and I just was too late. It was like, they didn't even have a sign up. They were like, yeah, you see, we ain't got it, right?
This is how it is, you know?
That's just how it is.
And that's the new planogram at Target.
Yeah, exactly. Not some merchandise around that. And also, I went to a grocery store yesterday and eggs were like starting at $3.99.
Mm.
And I'm like, oh boy.
Yeah, when eggs are expensive, it's real.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, so this is what's happening right now. Everyone wants to go back out in the street. But like what's happening for those who are staying home or who need to come home? Someone needs an egg. Everyone needs an egg at some point. Like what Except for our vegans, pardon me. But I don't know how y'all are doing it. I mean, yeah. If I can't find an egg, what are y'all eating? Anyway.
For real. Them plant that like that fake egg liquid, mm-hmm. It was expensive before all this.
Right, yeah.
You know, I don't know what y'all paying now. I bought my sister the vegan eggs, mm-hmm. the little juice box looking thing of eggs.
Right.
And it was like $9 before the quarantine. I was like, yo, listen, being vegan is a choice. You got to choose different. Like, this is crazy. But, yeah, I can't imagine what she's paying now for eggs, like, to have that same feeling. Like, I was going to start doing egg whites. I was talking about it at the last show until I saw the price of eggs. It's like, nah, I'm eating this whole egg.
All you want of it, throw yeah.
out? Yeah, I can't be throwing out 3/4 of the egg for my health.
Yeah.
You know, my heart ain't that important. Like we
no, not really. Not nearly as important as these prices, that's for sure. But yeah, it's been a lot. Also, I feel like now I should mention that over the past couple of weeks, we've been playing episodes that we recorded a little early.
Yeah.
Right? Because we had stuff that we had to do. And so all last week, as shit rained down on us from everywhere, I was just like, do a topical podcast, they said. Like, oh, boy. Because I know that people are going to turn on the podcast and they're going to go, I can't wait to hear what they say about. And we're like, yeah.
Nah, B.
We weren't there for that yet. So,
yeah, there was something that happened. This is how much should happen. There's something that happened the day before we normally record last week, I was like, damn, we should have talked about that. I don't even remember what that was. Like, I don't have the faintest idea what that was. And when it happened, I was like, damn, we missed that. Couldn't tell you. Like, life has, like, been consistently giving us new news. You know, Mercury out here, yo. Doing what he can. Retrograding all over the place, okay? I'm on board. I want someone to blame. Why not blame Mercury, okay? I don't even like that planet.
Wow, that's harsh.
You know? Because I'm just being real. I might have got a bad first impression, but all I know about is this retrograding business. It don't prograde.
Well, if it makes you feel better, all of the planets retrograde at some point.
But nobody talk about the other retrogrades.
Because none of the other planets are about communication. That's See? Why.
They keep Mercury to themselves.
Mercury has a better PR system.
The other planets sound like New Yorkers, okay? They look down, okay?
Yeah, I would recommend everyone look to see when Venus goes into retrograde because that planet controls love and relationships.
Okay.
And you may be able to make some correlations based on how your love life or relationships have gone. Check to see what Venus was doing at the time. And also, Venus also, I believe, controls like appearances.
Mm.
So if you got a bad haircut and it took a while to grow out, let's see what Venus was doing.
Okay.
If you tried to color your hair and it was supposed to be a lovely, like, you know, just kind of a sun-kissed, lights, little bits of blonde, and it all turned out orange and or green. See what Venus was doing. But also, maybe don't go back to whoever did your hair before.
Yeah.
Think about that. But yeah, so many things.
Avoid and her. Maybe her name was Venus.
Maybe it was. Yeah.
You know, avoid her.
Also, I'm not thrilled that I'm this person. I'm not thrilled that I'm check the planets person. I'm not, but I mean, it's as good a thing as any. You know what I mean? It feels harmless enough. I don't have to tithe to anybody. I'll do that.
I'm with it. Listen, I don't know if we'd click the same way, Sha, if you was anything else. Okay. I love that you are this. This is beautiful.
Oh boy.
Sincerely, I think it's great. I have noticed the last week I went on like a like get tidy frenzy. Like I did a ton of like errands around the house.
Mm.
Like I felt like I was getting ready.
Right. Okay.
I did like a ton of like stuff on my to-do list. over the last like 4 days.
Okay.
Although like to people watching from home, I know my office looks the same from this angle. The other 98% of this room drastically different right now. Okay.
You redid your office?
The whole thing is different. Like, it's crazy how little it shows in this one angle because everything else. I was just thinking about that right now. I'm looking at the camera like nobody is going to know what I did. But I promise you, this is not the same space. I did so much work in here. It's crazy. They will notice it soon. There's a couple things that I got that I'm shipping in that'll like kind of show a difference or even on this angle. But I did a lot over the last week.
You're shipping in things so that people can see the difference?
Yeah, you're going to see what I'm happening. I'm doing work here, Sha. We take it over.
Boy. Okay.
War report for the 99 and 2000.
Oh, okay? Great. That's exactly when I need it.
We out here. We can't gang, you know?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I felt like a need to like get ready.
Okay. So, yeah,
I've been doing that a lot.
Yeah. So that's probably you like preparing for whatever. Just be patient for the next 3 weeks because your plans, and I know that you're a planner, and when things are off, it throws you off your game and you want to move wildly in another direction.
Yeah.
Wait it out.
Okay.
Just take a beat or two before making a drastic decision because it may just work itself out. You just got to give it time and be super patient with it.
Okay. Because I was like sincerely debating on doing a very like drastic thing like this whole week.
Yeah. Give it a minute because it's, everything is in complete disarray. I just had something like a conversation with a coworker that I was going to do something drastic to based on what they said, but then I just kind of sat with it and I'm like, no, I'm not going to do anything because I'd be doing more than necessary for something that I don't even think is a problem yet. I need to wait for it to become a problem.
Yeah.
Instead of trying to see like, oh, it could be a problem this way, so I better do this and that. It's a lot of spinning in mud, you know? So I'm just going to wait. When it becomes a problem, then I will get my dander up. But in the meantime, I'm just going to let folks talk whatever wildness they want to talk. And I'm going to go, okay.
See, this is why I think more people should do astrology. Like, real shit. Yo, because like, I don't know what part of astrology leads to you thinking the way you think, but that was just good life advice. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if astrology gets you that shot, yo, you should teach that shit. Like, I don't care what it is.
No, I could never teach it because I'm a true idiot. There's so much science to it, and I'm not paying attention to the science part. I only want the part of the horoscopes that's printed in newspapers where they're like, you may have a great day, or it may rain. And I'm like, great, that's all I need to know. You know, I don't want to – in no way learned enough for the rest of it. I mean, a lot of my life experience and my life advice is based on me being lazy. So I just want to give you the easiest way possible to deal with a thing, which usually is just like, take a deep breath, think like, do I really need to get all worked up? And then work from there. Yes, I do. Okay. Then get worked up. No. All right. Let's give it a few hours then and see if you still want to get worked up or whatever. Yeah. It's a lot of my advice on moving and throwing things away and clearing out stuff is don't hold anything longer than 3 seconds.
Mm.
Because longer than 3 seconds will give you a chance to go, aw, and now you've kept it. You have it, go, all right, I don't need this. Or when was the last time I used this? If you haven't used it in the past, I'll be sweet. If you haven't used it in the past 2 years, go on and chuck it. You're probably good. If you got it, if you had to dust it off, go on and chuck it. Like, if it was at the very top or the very bottom behind something, you don't use it. Go on and get rid of it however you need to get rid of it.
Okay. Now, this is my one issue with that. I agree with that in theory.
Yes.
And I want to do that in my heart every time I go to clean up. The challenge is I'm also like a dollar person. So every time I want to throw something out, I think I should eBay this and then it stays there forever.
When was the last time you eBayed anything?
Real talk, probably like 4 years ago.
Okay, so you ain't going to do it.
Yeah, no, I'm not. I'm just saying in my heart, that's right. The problem.
Yeah.
Like, I agree with you. Like, I should get rid of this, but I don't, mm-hmm. I feel bad throwing it out.
Yeah.
I feel like I should eBay it.
Or and then give it never away. Goes anywhere. See, also the problem is you always trying to make a buck.
It's yeah, not no, I'm not denying that.
You're always trying to make a buck. I just want it gone. So I will put it in a bag and then I will take the bag somewhere or I will.
Okay.
Like, I recently took part in a clothing swap. With a lot of women in comedy. We got together, we brought in our things, set it up, and then everyone could go. And then whatever was left over was bagged up and taken to a Goodwill.
Oh, that's right? Dope.
Yeah. So I, and it's kind of the easiest way for me because I don't know what in New York, what the Goodwill drop-off situation is like. Whereas, I mean, in Atlanta, I was dropping off stuff. I was in thrift stores a lot, and I'm at Old Navy heavy. And then I'm like, nope, I don't need any of this. And I get rid of stuff. So I was always getting rid of things as I was bringing more crap in. And I've had a harder time doing that in New York. Partially because I don't have a vehicle and partially because I don't exactly know how it works here. So so I was just like, yeah, I can, I'll do that. I'll bring stuff. And I brought a suitcase, like a big duffel bag full of things. And I left with one shirt and a clutch. That wasn't mine. Just another shirt. I was like, I'll wear this. And then a little bag and my empty suitcase. And I was like, fantastic. Wonderful. That stuff was taking up too much room in my closet and I needed to get it gone. So, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, if there's any male comedian clothing swaps for dudes that wear 3X or more, hit me up.
Yeah, that was the other thing is I sometimes wouldn't go to clothing swaps because it's all just a bunch of little ladies.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I'm not dropping my big girl clothes off to a bunch of little ladies so that they can then alter it and it's not available for the big girls who need clothes.
Right.
That's been a problem in thrift stores is that little women go in and they grab all the big sizes and then they take them home and they alter it to fit them. Meanwhile, us big girls are out here trying to squeeze our way into a schmedium or some shit because that's all that's, you know what I mean? It's terrible. It's terrible.
So, oh, man. All of this because Mercury retrograde. You see what I'm talking about? Planet is out of control.
Out of control. There's
somebody's got to do something about it, okay? Yeah. Pull them aside, okay? Talk to Mercury. Let them know what's going on. Mercury, rein us in. Mainly only retrograde twice a year next year, you know? That's it. Be considerate.
No, never. There are four times this year. It's too hard.
Too much, okay? Mm-hmm. Mercury, we got to talk, okay? Out of control. Let's get into the news.
Okay.
Almost half of the UK single men wash their bed sheets just once every 4 months, study finds. That's right, every retrograde, roughly. almost half of the UK single men don't change their bed sheets up to four. Don't change their bed sheets for up to 4 months. A survey of 2,250 UK adults has found that men have significantly worse hygiene than women when it comes to their bedding. I don't think this was a surprise to anybody. They did a. Oh man, have you experienced anything like this, Sha?
I dated a guy and he bought more bed sheets while we were dating.
Okay.
He probably had two sets and I was like, that's not enough. Because you're not washing them enough. So you're going to have to up that. but I've definitely had conversations with young men where I'm like, how many sets of sheets do you have?
Yeah.
And you gotta wash them, like wash those pillowcases. And I mean, you know, and there are some people who know that they need to do that, but I mean, I guess maybe they were all in the military, so they were trained to. I don't know how to.
For comparison's sake, by the way, 62% of single women over the age of 18 change their bedding once every 2 weeks, whereas only 29% of single men wash their sheets at the same frequency. Instead, 45% of single men admitted to only washing their sheets every 3 to 4 months, and 12% admitted to only washing them when they remember, which could have been even longer.
And I bet they don't have a backup set either. So they just...
That's the pick.
It's just their one set of sheets. And then when they remember, they wash and then put it back on. And then we back in the saddle again for 3 to 4 months.
Admittedly, like, my sheet game has been better than me. Because I've always been with women. Like, my mom took care of it. And then, like, Gabby did an exceptional job with it. And, like, there was no middle. Like, when I was dating, I was at home. I had a studio adjacent to my parents' apartment.
Right.
So, like, yeah, like, that just got taken care of. And we owned the laundromat. So, like, my laundry got done.
Wow. You would be a mess then if left by yourself.
Oh, 100%. Like, I learned laundry, like, early, but, like, doing it, like, as a... Like, to me, doing the laundry was take it to the laundromat and our employee did the laundry.
Oh, God.
You know? Like, I did it.
1%.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to sit here and lie. Like, I was like, my hands was getting dirty and shit. Like, I didn't know that shit. You know? I learned to do laundry at, like, 19. Like, for real learned.
Oh, wow.
I knew the steps, like, because I saw it and because I had to explain it to people using our machines. When, like, I was in charge. But, like, actually, like, doing laundry, I didn't do that till I was an adult. And then, like, even, like if it wasn't for Gabby, I would have had, like, a layered system. Like, I don't know what you call the one that's right on the mattress.
The fitted sheet?
Yeah, like, the fitted sheet, I'd have, like, 12 of those. And I'd have progressively less as you went up. You know, like the thick quilt thing that's on the top that keeps you warm.
Right.
That's not even touching me. So right, I would have one of those, maybe two.
Sure. I'll give you that. That's and like then, a duvet. I mean, it depends. It probably was a comforter or a quilt.
Yeah.
A lot of people like duvets with duvet covers, and then they switch out the cover. They may not wash the big old pillow stuffing that's on the inside. Some do. If you do, you probably have a machine in your home.
Okay.
Because I've yet to see anyone washing a duvet in a public laundromat. But
see, I'm doing all that. I got the machine, and it's in our bedroom, so we do the whole thing now. But I'm not gonna lie, like, I'm the one, like, volunteering. Like, I've never thought in my life we should do the laundry. Not once. It has never come up. Every time I've done the laundry, someone has said, yo, it's time for the laundry.
So it's never occurred to you, like, oh, we're out of... Yeah, see, you gotta live a life where you run out of underwear and you're unable to buy more right away.
And exactly. That's been the only other thing. Like, I've had times where I've run out of underwear, but I've always just bought more underwear. Like, that made more sense to me because I felt like I was solving both problems. I was like, one, I'm getting underwear that I need now, and two, I don't want to remember to do laundry, so now I've prolonged.
That's still a problem. You're not solving that problem. You're actually compounding that problem. Because now you've just added 3 to 5 more pieces of things that you're not going to wash on time.
Right, but my purse is going to wash it at my dad's laundromat.
Oh, my God.
So it's all going to get washed that one day.
I love you, Gastor. I don't know how I feel about you just leaving your laundry. I did not realize how many people drop off their laundry for service at laundromats.
It's life changing.
No, never. I will never do that. Never.
Mm-mm. Why?
Why? I don't trust them to wash my clothes. No.
Nah.
I've been in laundromats and I watch people drop off their laundry. And I've watched people give these detailed, you got to use this for this and blah, 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 and dry it on this. And they're like, yep, got it down. They're writing it down. And then I watch them dump all that shit into one machine and then dump all that shit into the dryer and then fold it up and do it. And then I'm like, nah, I've seen too much. Mm-mm, hanging out here. No.
That's exactly why, though. I don't want to think about it, Shy. You say that whole list for yourself. That's like for you. Like when I leave my kids with my parents, I know they don't give a fuck about their allergies at right. all. You know, right. I accept the fact that like my kid, 1 in 90, might die of cashews the day to day with my parents. That's just part of it. You know, that's how they get stronger. You know,
I can't. I buy cheap clothing. I'll just put that out there. Okay. Not necessarily in a fast fashion way. I'm usually just buying cheap basics. I'm not trying to buy a lot of cheap clothing to keep up with trends. It's just I don't make a lot of money. I got to get the inexpensive clothing. So in order for it to last, I got to do wild things like hang it dry, right? Or things that I know will shrink too much for where I'm pushing it. Like, okay, I need to hang that dry. I need to do, you know, I don't know. Mr. Man at the laundromat don't care about my clothing.
At all.
So I care about my clothing. Therefore, I will wash my clothes.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I have old Navy shirts that are easily 12 to 13 years old.
That's wild.
Old
Navy? That's impressive.
Old Navy, yeah. That's something.
That's and like a $4 shirt depending on the sale.
Yeah, oh, it's always going to be a $4 shirt with me. I'm a wait because I know their cycles. I know how they do. But I just would dry. I'd hang dry or look like because I'm like, I don't know. I like how they did this shirt. And I know that every year that they redo a shirt, they change a little something with it.
Right.
Right. So you're like, oh, I like how the hem of this shirt is. And then next year you're like, oh, look, they've got V-neck shirts again. They done changed the hem or the fabric's a little weird or so. You know what I mean? Nothing is consistent.
Try to save another 5 cents or something.
Right, yeah. So now all the seams are crooked. You know, it hangs funny. And I'm like, man, I wish you would make it like you did these other ones. So now I got to hang those dry because these are now a legacy item. And I can't trust them to go back to that.
Okay. That's fair. Yeah. That's fair. Yeah. I've always done like my hourly calculation. If it was like, you know, like 70 cent a pound back when I used to do this drop off, I don't know what it is now, like 60, 70 cent, like it would be like $25 to do my laundry or something. Right. And it would take me 2 hours to do my laundry. I know I make more than $12.50 an hour, you know? So, like, that was my logic. I was like, I'd rather just go work 2 more hours and I don't got to go do laundry, you know?
No, I take those 2 hours to either eat during the wash one and clean during the dry one or just clean the house while I know that stuff is going in the... I used to... Look, here's what I used to do in Atlanta. If I didn't have a car, I don't think outside of living with my parents, I lived any place where there was a washer dryer in my building, in my unit, in my whatever.
Yeah.
So I would have to go places to wash and I'd have to carry my laundry places. There were some work days where with or without a car, I would carry my laundry, usually without a car, on the bus, like on my head.
Okay.
Because I'd have to get to work, and then there's a laundromat a block down, and I would just wash clothes while I was at work. I've only lost 2 pairs of jeans that way.
Respect.
And that someone went in and stole my 2 pairs of jeans out of the dryer. And that's pretty good odds, considering. Oh, yeah. So, that's what I would do, because I, you know, it was the only time I could do it. Like, okay. Yeah, like, I don't know, man. I don't think I could let anyone else wash my clothes. No one else is going to love my cheap Uniqlo clothes like I do.
Listen, I respect it. I love you for it. I love that you have that care. I don't. I want the whole opposite of that in all of life. I want to not know what anything... I don't want to know how anything is done in my life. I just want it done. If I get to that place in life, Shy, it's going to be beautiful. I'm going to be the happiest you've ever seen. And I'm a pretty happy person in general. But I will be in genuine bliss if I don't know how anything works. I don't want to know how any of it works. I don't want to know what meat looks like before it's cooked. I don't want to know how to turn on the vacuum. None of that. Like, I want to hear about it. Like when someone explains vacuum cleaners, I want to be excited because of the technology. That's how rare it's been, you know? I want to be into the idea, like as a study, like when someone talks about washing laundry, I want it to be because I'm watching a description of like a laundromat like employee on Vice on a documentary. That's why I want to like learn about it. You know, I'm be like, oh, that's crazy. You know, props to them, and then I buy them an extra nice Christmas gift that year. You know, that's what I want life to be. Admittedly, it's not there. You know, and I appreciate the people that do it. I think it's beautiful that, you know, you could do anything and make a living, and there's people that make the world function on all scales. I think that's dope. Mm-hmm. And they make their living off of people like me that don't know shit, you know? As me. I don't know any of these tools. I don't know any of these tasks. I throw out trash. I'm good at that. I can show you how to tie a knot off of the top of a garbage bag that don't have strings. I'm good. I know certain blue-collar tasks. Uh-huh. But laundry was never one of them.
Right. For the most part, you need to have soft hands.
Amen. Amen.
Okay.
That's my future. I know my place in life. It is what it is.
Yeah, as long as you know. That's good. You know?
And I'm appreciative of it. Like, that's the one thing I will say that's different. Like, I'm not above it. Because, like, I saw people and I know people that did it. Like, my dad owned a laundromat. He did laundry. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He knows what it's like to do laundry. His hands is trash. You know what I mean? Yeah. I shake that dude's hands, my shit gets cut up. You know, his hands are sandpaper, so that I could have baby hands. Okay,
there is something to that because I did used to clean houses, and I do like clean things and use my hands because sometimes it's easier than whatever tool I'm supposed to use.
Yeah,
and my hands are terrible.
Yo, it ruins them.
they're I mean, I lotion them all the time and it just goes in and my hands are like, is that all you got? And I'm like, oh geez.
Okay. I worked at UPS for years. I loaded up boxes for Frito-Lay. Nothing did track like anything to my hands like detergent did to my dad's. Okay. I don't know what that shit is, but it's crazy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Shouts to y'all out there cleaning your clothes. You know, I know that's a low bar to give a shout out to, but I'm impressed. God damn it.
But clearly it's needed since the people in the UK guys are not washing it. And I'm glad we didn't even ask the US because I'm sure those numbers are even scarier. So,
amen. We out here, baby.
You'll be able to spot them by the rashes. That's how you know they're out here.
In other news, man with nine wives has sex schedule to fulfill my sexuality at any cost. That's right. What? Having multiple hanky-panky partners is apparently a lot of work, says a Brazilian model and polygamist who notoriously married nine women. Now claims he has had to create a sex schedule to be sure each wife's needs are met. They all want to fulfill my sexuality at any cost, says author O. Orso. As he told the Jam Press of his salacious play spinning. The model and swinger, who was married to fellow swinger Luana Kazaki, made waves in marital circles last year after tying the knot with eight additional women in Sao Paulo because he wanted to protest against monogamy. Alas, the nuptials weren't legally binding as polygamy is outlawed in Brazil. The arrangement might have sounded like a dream come true. However, Urso said he struggled to satisfy all his partners equally. So he had to establish a romp rota. Initially, I tried to have sex by appointment, said Urso of the juggling act. Needless to say, the hubby found out that it was difficult trying to manage it all. So he had to come up with a timetable. But even that caused problems.
I do not feel for this man at all.
Yeah, this is the shittiest plight ever.
This is ridiculous. Give me a fucking break. Don't you know the world is falling apart and we're supposed to care about you and your nine wives? Which doesn't even sound right. I keep thinking you're saying nine lives like a cat. And I'm like, what? I'm so confused.
I love that nine lives sounded more realistic to you.
It does. It absolutely does.
Oh, okay, we're talking about a cat. Okay, cool.
Yeah, and this little dork has these women, and he's trying to sexually... Man, they ain't thinking about you, bruh. They're not thinking about you. You ain't doing it. Trust me, you're not doing it. They are going elsewhere.
Every single one of these women.
They for sure are going elsewhere, or the self-esteem is so low. Like, I want better for everyone involved. except maybe the dude.
Yeah.
But I just want better for everyone involved. You don't have to this. You don't have to listen to this chode. Give me a break. Just be go out there and do something else if that's what you want. I mean, like, if you are a swinger, that's fine. But boo, basically, boo.
Yeah. I don't know. This felt like. Like, I've seen, like, people that, like, follow polygamy. It does not look this sexy. Like,
yeah, that's the other thing. They're all, I mean, as closer to conventionally attractive than not, right?
Yeah.
These pictures of these thin, like, I don't understand. Boo. I don't understand. How do you even trick these people into doing it? This feels like a PR stunt. I don't care that you have to schedule. There are people with one partner who have to schedule sex with their partner. You know Amen. What I mean? So what's your job? What's your job? How do you have time? How do you have time to service everybody? What do you do for money?
Yeah. What's your diet like? You know,
what's your diet? When do you eat? Are you hydrated?
Yeah.
Boy, I don't believe none of this. Get out of here.
Yeah, nah, none of this is real.
No.
Mm-mm. Yeah, nah. New York Post. We got to talk. Y'all are really stretching the idea of article. And
yeah,
news.
They really are. They really are.
This is pushing it. Yeah, I'm pro, like, live your life. I really am. I do think there's, like, a point of diminishing returns. Like, I don't know how polygamy works. I really don't. If you're a listener out there and you're a polygamist, let me know. Like, what is, you know? Like, for real.
Yeah,
like,
all of y'all let us know. All
for real,
y'all.
The whole squad.
I want everybody to, yeah, let us know how it works, how it's working for you.
Like, this is the one thing I've, like, figured out. Like, and maybe I'm wrong. I'm as an observer of polygamous, it's not so much that, like, you can't have multiple partners, is that there's still a number, like, where it's too far. You know what I mean? Mm. Like, there's a reason that couples work. It's not because it's the right number. It's because it's the easiest number. I only got to pay attention to one other person. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't because I'm sure other people were like, yo, we should get three involved. Like, and it sound cool in theory till you got to make two other people happy all the time. You know what I mean? Like, there's a reason. So, like, I don't know how polygamy works, but I promise you the rate of it not working goes higher the more the number of people are in. That would be my guess.
That's why 9 seems silly to me, because that's more than days of the week.
Yeah.
Why would you have to, your schedule's going to be nuts.
Yeah.
What's wrong with 7?
Seriously.
Stop at 7.
I don't even know, like, have you seen a house in any state where, is there a state anywhere where there's like a standard 9-bedroom house?
I mean, you got to have a compound, or some of these wives are sharing bedroom. Like, what's going on? Are you all in? As far as I'm concerned, if they got their own apartment and you're the one without, and you're just bouncing from apartment to apartment, I don't know if y'all are really married anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know. If you don't have a, you know, like, who's the main one? Where does your mail go?
Who's your emergency contact?
Yeah, like,
who's theirs?
Because I mean each other probably,
right?
I bet you anything there's at least two of your wives. It's like, don't put my name down for nothing. I'm not accepting your packages. I'm not your emergency contact. I ain't doing none of that shit.
Just one wife pissed off. I keep having a sign for your shit.
Yeah, I'm not doing this anymore.
How much you order from Amazon, okay?
Absolutely.
Kudos to the wives for keeping the peace in that. But I feel like in about 5 years, at least 6 of y'all are going to, like, leave this and, like, every now and then reach out to the other ones. Like, yeah, that was crazy, right? Yeah, yeah. I don't know what we was thinking.
I'm looking forward to the book that will chronicle that at least 3 of you will write together. I'm looking forward to that.
I will say one thing that I do find that is an advantage to this for this young man. Mm-hmm. This is a loophole with the bedsheet laundry thing.
Oh, you know? Yeah. Well, he doesn't own any seats.
Yeah. He can smash, he can leave.
If he doesn't have an address, he also does not own any sheets. He would not know when to wash sheets. He only knows when to get up and go away the following morning.
Oh, man. Never change, homie. Never change. Actually, no, you should change significantly. You're a horrible person. Oh, man. Growth has never been needed more. In other news, Drake roasts a troll by following his wife and DMing her. That's right. Drake brought the smoke to social media troll that was following by following the guy's wife on Instagram. The whole ordeal began last week on Tuesday when Drizzy commented on an Instagram post from an NBA shooting coach named Lethal Shooter, who was showing support for enthusiastic fathers of the NBA, players like LeVar Ball and T. Morant. Drake then backed up the coach's sentiments in the comments by explaining that, in his opinion, it only makes sense that a father would be beyond thrilled that his son made it to an elite level of professional basketball. He also said if he were in that position, he would likely be just as competitive. At this point, an Instagram user who goes by Sedibo Ybegan, I don't know how to, I think I said that right.
Yeah, I think so.
Replied to the rapper by saying, "Your son probably play with ghostwriters." Then Drake, that's when Drake decided to attack it. And he said, "I just followed your girl because she's probably miserable and needs some excitement in her life." My man Drake, my man is all about it here. And then he DM'd the young lady. The DM said, "I'm here for you, ma." Oh, my goodness. That is absolutely beautiful. I'm not necessarily a Drake fan of his music. I think it's cool. I'm not anti-Drake, per se. It's not my first thing that I reach to. But, man, am I a fan of this level of petty. This was executed like absolutely perfectly. I aspire to be this successful, to be able to do this on occasion. I want to be good as a person 99% of the time so that I could be this petty 1% of the time. Mm-hmm. And it'd be like, okay, like in the grand scheme of things. Like, I want God to be like, "I'm going to let this slide, but that was fucked up." You know?
Okay. Huh. I'm not a Drake person. I don't know. He's never really done it for me.
Okay.
If I enjoy his music, it's usually maybe he has a feature on someone's song, you know? Mm. Maybe he's got like a verse somewhere or something, or a song is so ubiquitous that you just hear it and you're like, "Yeah, that's Drake." But I've never searched him out.
Right.
So that he even, I am not surprised that he took it, that this was the comment that he took to heart and got mad at, because, he did say, "If I was ever in this position, I'd probably be just as competitive," talking about, you know, if he were to ever have a son that was competitive in something. And I mean, it is nice for someone to remind him that, like, "Oh yeah, you do have a son and we know about him thanks to Pusha T." So these are feelings you could have had and we would have never known because you weren't about to tell us about your son at all. So there's that.
Now he's on his lap at NBA games.
Yeah. Just so I guess I see why this hit him like that.
Yeah.
But it's such a weird move. Just like she ain't asked for none of this. You know what I mean? She's just trying to live her good life. She has her own Instagram account where she had her own thing going on. And now here's Drake in her in her mentions talking about, I'm here for you, Ma. And she's like, what the fuck is this? And now her husband, also what this story doesn't talk about is how after this, her husband talked about, he blew this up like it within like days. He had them like hosting a night at a club and he made all these posts and he was going to sell these t-shirts. And he was just being a lame about it.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of just being like, ah, ha, ha, he got into my girl's DMs, which honestly, Drake also kind of lucked out that this guy didn't roll up on him.
Fair.
You know what I mean? I mean, I guess corny recognizes corny.
Game, yeah.
Recognize game. So I guess you can figure out which dude is not going to be mad that you rolled up on their girl.
I kind of think that's what happened. Like, I feel like Drake saw, like, the dude for what he was. It was another, mm-hmm. like, petty guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, oh, you like one of me. And it wasn't so much, like, I think people misview this. It wasn't like, it's not hate. Like, it wasn't like he angry so much as like, oh, I don't get to play this game often, you know, where like someone could be petty back and forth with me. Like, he was excited. He got to play petty with a fellow petty dude. So it was like a tip of the cap to like a fellow petty dude.
That's what you think from Drake's end. It was a tip of the cap.
Yeah, because like he could have done something grimy. I feel like the I'm here for you, Ma, is clearly like a silly joke. Like, I think they like if he saw them in person after the fact, he'd be like, yeah, you know, I'm fucking around, right? But like, also, I could def do that. But like, I'm fucking around. Like, he could have said that.
Yeah, I guess maybe it just doesn't sit right with me that he had to drag his girl into it. I think that dragging his wife into it, I mean, find a better way to be petty.
I agree with that, but that's because he's a bad comedian. You know what I'm saying? He's peak petty.
I guess on both ends, yeah, they are bad comedians, both he and the dude.
Yeah, like, I appreciate the petty level. The comedian part, you can't execute that. Like, I can't hold him to that standard. That's not what he does well. The petty, excellent petty. You know, petty match. I approve of it. I actually approve of the petty response by the guy. Clearly, someone that hasn't been in his dynamic before, trying to maximize petty exposure. Do what you do. As a comedian, not impressed, but he's not a comic. Like, if T.I. was doing this, I'd roast him. He's trying to be a comic. Can't hold Drake to that.
But T.I. would not. See, I don't think T.I. Could even take this as well as Drake did.
Right. He's not a petty dude. He's different. He's angry. He would actually, yeah, like, angry. Say
wild shit.
He would
actually roll
shit.
Up and yeah. take the girl.
Exactly.
Allegedly.
Yeah. Have Tiny line by it right now. Uh-huh.
Allegedly. But yeah, Drake's not gonna do that. Drake's too goofy.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, Drake's goofy. I don't know. I mean, I guess it was fun, but I also am just like, man, Drake, why don't you just leave everyone alone? Yeah. Just leave everyone alone. Leave us alone. You know, you said this on Instagram. People are going to say wild, stupid shit. This wasn't even the wild or stupid.
Right.
It's just like, you use ghostwriters. Your son will too. Ha, 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 ha. It didn't make sense. It wasn't even worth it. Like, that wasn't even a joke worth responding to, which is probably why that dude was surprised anyone did, because he's probably written corny shit under celebrity comments and posts for years now.
Yeah.
And has never gotten so much as a bite. And now his wife was followed by Drake. So he's like, well, we got to get t-shirts made. And I'm sure his wife was like, nigga, if you don't just sit down. like,
look what Drake did right here. Like, one, okay? He brought a tent. He gave positive reinforcement to these two dads in the NBA, first of all.
Right.
You know, B, mm-hmm. He helped show this young lady the pettiness level of her man, you know? Now she can make better decisions about their future.
Oh, she knew.
Yeah? You think so?
Yeah. Yeah.
But now everybody knows. Like, right now, I promise you, she got homegirls like, yo, you with that t-shirt making dude?
there are some difficult conversations happening in group chats. I agree.
That's what I'm saying. Like it was a moment of like, yo, listen, we kind of talked to you about him before, but this crossed the line. Like, mm-hmm. you know, what else is he going to throw in on a t-shirt about your life? You know?
Yeah, that's true. I believe that's definitely happening.
And Drake brought that to life for them. Like, this is a fight that they would have had in like 6-7 years. Drake is making it happen today. You know? This is one-on-one counseling, you know? People pay big money for that.
I guess so.
I'm appreciative of Drake for this. You know, helping couples move forward in their relationship. Shouts to Drake. Keep doing what you do, bro. Petty King, okay?
That's so funny. Yeah. Petty King.
Scorpio Gang. Yeah, oh, right. Baby.
I forgot about that.
I support all our nonsense, okay? I don't care how wrong it is. We out here.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
We make great average music, okay? Another news. NASA to launch naked pictures of humans to space in hope of attracting aliens. That's right. NASA scientists plan to launch pictures of naked humans into space in hope of luring aliens to us. The depictions will also include an invitation to respond should an intelligent alien race find a space nudes. Fortunately, the hypothetical aliens shouldn't be too shocked by the unsolicited news. The pictures aren't graphic photographs of naked humans, but a drawing of a naked man and woman next to a depiction of DNA. The man and woman are waving in an attempt to look more inviting. NASA scientists revealed the image in a study that's part of a project called Beacon in the Galaxy. The main aim of the Beacon in the Galaxy project is to send a message to any aliens, civilizations that could be out there.
Okay. I wish we'd stop. How is a pixelated drawing of naked humans going to invite anything? Do we really want this? Do we? NASA, let me talk to you for a second. Is this what you really want?
Yeah.
I want you to think this through, okay? I mean, look, I get that you're trying to make a connection out here, and it seems dire, and you ain't doing nothing but getting older. So, you know, you got to pull some extra tricks out your hat or whatever. And what's been working, you know, conversation or radio waves or, you know, satellites, light things, none of that's working. You're throwing up all the things and nothing's working. And so now you've got to go, you got to work blue.
Yeah.
And you're going with naked pictures. But like, I don't know if anyone really wants that. And no one requested it.
Yeah.
So I think I understand your zeal for making a connection, but I don't think this is the way to do it. I really don't think unsolicited anything. Like I don't think anyone asked for any of the other shit that we were throwing up out there either, but definitely this feels a bridge too far.
Yeah. I feel like somebody at NASA, like, just ordered like one of those paint by the numbers things from Amazon and they just want to show off they work. And they're like, yo, how can I get this out there?
Well, I'm worried about what wolves if NASA has thought about who or what will respond and what kind of mood they're going to be in. Because now what's Earth? Like the cock tease of the Milky Way? We've sent out...
We Amsterdam, Sha.
Oh, no, not even. No one's come back here yet for fun. So we're not even Amsterdam. Amsterdam is established fun. Okay. We're not even that. We're like a small town that's just trying to get money, like to pay for, and that this is the only thing that their Chamber of Commerce can think of. Just like, well, I mean, have we tried naked pictures? Like, this is not going to get folks to our small town. And if they are, they're going to be looking for one thing only. Where are those naked pixelated things? Where's your pixelated DNA? And then we're going to try to sit them down and just be like, no, we just want to talk. That's bullshit. We're being a cock tease. And you're not going to pull a high quality alien. You're not going to pull a high quality alien.
That's right.
By putting your stuff out there like that.
Okay.
word to Kevin Samuels.
Oh man.
You're not gonna get a high quality alien.
That's it. All these aliens read Steve Harvey. Okay.
That's right.
They follow Kevin Samuels, all his YouTube videos, RIP.
Yeah, RIP. Hey, man, you gotta be smart out here.
You know what I mean? You know? Red pill culture, okay?
Yeah, like, I don't know. Are we thinking like a man, acting like an alien? I'm not sure. There's something that we're doing, but it's not, I don't think it's right. It's a little, it does not sit right with me.
Oh, man. All right. Get it right, okay? Finish the book. I'll send you a copy, Earth. Okay, NASA? Y'all can read up. Forget your act together. You know, what this made me realize is that as much, like, we take it for granted that things get better. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we just assume, like, just the new iPhone coming. Yo, something, there's 1,000 people at Apple busting their ass.
Right.
To make the iPhone a little bit better every year. And we just assume it's going to be better every year. Nah, right. There's really intelligent people focused on that shit. Mm-hmm. For whatever reason, NASA ain't popping no more. Like, it just stopped being as cool as it was in the 60s. We got on the moon, and the talent level just stopped showing up. Like, people was like, ah, that's cool. And this is the best we got now. Like, it's regressed.
Yeah, I feel like we are not... Like, I was talking to NASA as if it was a middle-aged person sending out nudes unsolicited. But I think it's because, as a middle-aged, you know, government agency, it has not changed with the times.
Yeah.
And so I think maybe there are other things that that maybe are of more importance to people, to get people interested, because I feel like we should concentrate on getting people interested,
right?
Instead of we chasing all these high class aliens, and they ain't even looking at us. Meanwhile, there's people right here who are curious. Like, I feel like we should really be paying more attention to that instead of trying to catch these fast ass aliens who aren't interested. So, yeah, I don't know. I just don't think NASA's really thought this through. And I think they're trying to throw what seems like young ideas at it. And these young ideas just make it look older.
For real. All of this felt bad to me.
Yeah.
Like, I felt like the idea was old.
Yeah, this made me think
that NASA used old computers. Like, as soon as I saw it, like y'all drew this shit on a packet bell. Like, let me know. I'll send you a couple dollars, NASA. Like, I want y'all to go places. Mm-hmm. You know, this is rough. I'm disappointed, NASA. Like, y'all need this is the first time I thought, like, oh, I could have been an astronaut, like, for real. Like, I really believed it. Like, and I don't even, like, not even on some, like, I could have done it if I worked hard. I think I could do it now. Like, I could definitely draw better. I promise you my titties would have looked like real titties on these drawings. Okay?
Right, sure. I believe you.
I'd crush these drawings. Even if we did it on a computer. Like, I could crush this on MS Paint. This is trash. I don't want aliens thinking this is the best we could do.
Right, exactly. I don't know why they think that sending these almost childlike figures is going to get alien. I don't know. Do we know what the aliens want? Do they want to see us naked? And if so, is this the body parts they want to see?
Yeah.
Like, what if they just want a close-up of our ear? You know what I mean? Let's give them something they don't have. Like,
yeah, yo, come on.
At
the very least, I'm going to put this one thing out there to NASA, right? Look, if you're going to send drawings to attract aliens, I don't think the person that draws the picture should also work in NASA. You know, I think that's something you source out. You know what I mean? Just putting it out there,
to an actual artist.
Yeah.
Now they said they drew it in this way, in this fashion, this weird, like old school pixelated way, dashes and dots, a binary way, I guess, because they want it. They think that that's going to be easier for aliens to read.
But like, doesn't that assume the alien life form is dumber than us? I think they're smarter. If they're dumber, I don't want them coming here if they know less than us.
Yeah, no, absolutely. We're good on that.
Yeah, we got that. Yeah, like, we good.
No, I feel like we should all agree that aliens are definitely smarter. Mm-hmm. No one sent, I mean, they haven't sent us any naked pictures.
They're laughing at us right now. Like, look at these idiots.
Unless that's what a crop circle is, I don't believe they sent us any naked pictures.
Oh, man. Nah, so step your game up. Start a GoFundMe. Nah, I mean, buy a new computer, draw better titties. There's a lot of advice y'all need over there.
Start an OnlyFans. I don't
Seriously.
Know. Put those behind a paywall.
Yo, low-key, somebody should start an OnlyFans for those pixelated characters.
Someone probably
has. Nothing but pictures of these blue characters getting it on. Oh, man.
Oh my God.
You got my $5 a month, whichever person does that. In other news, anonymous donor pays around $300,000 to cover more than 100 graduates at Texas's Wiley College. Graduates from the historically black college in Texas were treated to quite a surprise this week as over 100 students at Wiley College's class of 2022 were told an anonymous donor had paid off their combined remaining balances of about $300,000. You are debt free. You do not owe the college a penny. If you have a balance, you had a balance. Wiley's president and CEO Herman Felton Jr. announced in a video that has since gone viral. Felton Jr. detailed the news in a press release this weekend. Our commitment to our students goes beyond their time while they are enrolled. We are constantly communicating with donors to assist students in these ways so that they can begin their after-college experience with less debt. We are grateful for this anonymous donor who will assist the students in paying off their balances to Wiley College and help us achieve institutional goals of graduating our students with little to no debt. The school added that the anonymous donor set graduates on a continued path to success and allows Wiley College to strengthen its commitment to providing an affordable, exceptional education. It's freaking dope. Now, many people will recognize Wiley College from the Denzel Washington starring movie The Great Debaters, which was based on the school's 1935 debate team.
Yeah, I saw that on a date.
Ugh. What happened?
I was just dating this guy, and he, when we decided to go to a movie, it was casual or whatever, but when we decided to go to a movie, he was like, I don't want to see any movie. I only want to see movies with black people.
Okay.
And I'm like, okay, that's great. But, I mean, that means we're not going to be going to the movies a lot. Sorry.
Okay.
So, you know, at that point, he was just like, let's go see this. And I'm like, all right, sure. And it was fine. But it's also just like, boo. I don't know. It was a good movie. I'm not saying it was a bad movie. I believe Denzel directed it.
Mm.
And it was a perfectly fine movie, but it also is just like afterwards, you know, we want to talk about the heaviness and the weight of, you know, being the first black to do. And I'm like, yo, bro, I just want some like crazy bread. You know what I mean? Like, I just want to go on a fun date. Like, I, you know, the first movie we went to was, You Got Served. I didn't realize it was a date. I thought we were just two people hanging out. So I was like, well, let's go see You Got Served. And I dare say that may have set the precedent where he's like, oh, okay, black people movies. And I'm like, not You Got Served, though. But I stopped him at White Girls. I was like, I'm not going to see White Girls. So we went to see Anchorman instead. And Anchorman's a very funny movie. I did enjoy it. But boy. I would have been very angry. Anyway, my point is, who do you think gave the money to the school? That was a hell of a tangent to get to. Who do you think gave the money to the school?
You think it was Denz?
Probably.
Yeah, that'd be dope.
I bet.
Yeah, I don't think he needs credit. I think he's got enough credit in life.
Yeah.
He's a humble dude. He doesn't need that.
Truly, just feels like something he would do is just be like, yeah, no, I did that.
Yeah, I think he's like a humble dude in that with stuff like that. Like, I think he's more than capable of doing something. And the money wouldn't be a lot to him either.
Right, yeah, I think he's got enough that he would be like, yeah, I can handle this.
Look at that. Look at that. Even if it wasn't true, props, Denzel. You know what I mean? For putting the idea out there. You know what I mean? I think that's awesome. Goodness. Yeah, this would be a great way to like celebrate graduation. I also like, I'm always like with stuff like this, I think of like that one student that like was slacking and like he's not laughing at his homeboy. Like, yo, like I left all 30 G's on the line. You paid most of your shit off. You know what I mean? Denzel paid off $300 and 30 racks on me, my G.
I didn't pay nothing. I paid
goddamn thing.
Oh, yeah, that is harsh. Yeah.
Nah, but that's dope. I think this is awesome. It's a incredible gift that I hope they appreciate and take advantage of. You know, get started out there, take some jobs, start some businesses. Ironically, all of these things kind of get you into debt again, but
right. But this time it's your debt.
Yeah, exactly. It's on your dream and on you taking a risk.
Right.
So exactly. I think that's beautiful. Sincerely, I think that's awesome. I hope more people are in a position to do it. I hope I'm in a position one day to like pay off debts. Admittedly, I will never do any of this shit anonymously. I want all my kudos. I want every flower sent to me. But
you
I will
would
do
name
this.
The gift after you.
Yeah,
like
for
everybody
sure.
got the Gastor El Monte gift.
100%. I would be fake humble. I would name it after my kid, and like still say it's about me.
Yeah, but you would call it the Gastor's kids gift.
Hell yeah. You know
you wouldn't
what I mean?
Even give their names. You would just be like the offspring of Gastor El Monte's gift.
As it should be, damn it. Okay. Because I made them too, okay? You know?
Oh boy.
Nah, but this is legit dope. Like, this made my day. I love seeing this. I hope more stuff like this continues to happen. Good luck to all of those students, too. Now, I mean, that's 100 kids out there, debt-free, kicking off the game. Change the world and all that.
Change the world.
Yo. I'm positive in my own way, Sha.
Yeah, no, it's a quiet thing. Yes.
The CDC tracked millions of phones to see if Americans were following COVID lockdown orders. That's right. The Center of Disease Control and Prevention bought access to the location data harvested from tens of millions of phones in the U.S. to perform analysis of compliance with curfews, track patterns of people visiting K-12 schools, and specifically monitor the effectiveness in the Navajo Nation, according to the CDC documents obtained by Motherboard. The documents also show that although the CDC used COVID-19 as a reason to buy access to the data more quickly, it intended to use it for more general CDC purposes. The location data is information on a device's location source from the phone, which can then show where a person lives, works, and where they went. The sort of data the CDC bought was aggregated, meaning it was designed to follow trends that emerge from movements of groups of people. But researchers have repeatedly raised concerns with how location data can be de-anonymized and used to track specific people.
Yo, look, CDC, why y'all? What y'all need this shit for?
Serious.
Like, I see that, you know, you're saying it's so that you can make sure, or you can not even make sure, but see what people were doing to see if your policies worked. But you changed policies through this pandemic. You changed policies at the drop of a hat, at the swish of the wind. Like, you never stuck with anything because you were severely compromised.
Right.
In a way. So, like, don't give me that. I don't believe you anymore, CDC, and it hurts my heart because, you know, we're from the same city. But it makes me sad.
Two things. One, I agree with you. But two, I want to point out that your loyalty to the CDC because of its location sounds a lot like my loyalty to Drake because of the Scorpio thing. Just want to put it out there. Equally frivolous reasons.
Yeah, no, absolutely. The reason that I stand on things is very stupid. All my reasons are stupid. There's nothing logical about any of my reasons to decide to make a stand. They're all truly dumb.
Yo, my issue with this was, like, I don't even have a problem with them tracking the data for this reason. Mm-hmm. My issue is I feel like I would have agreed to this. And not everybody, but, like, enough Americans would have agreed that they would have still gotten the information by being up and up. Hey, listen, I want to know if this is working because we're in extreme times. And they would have sent the, I would have gotten a Apple pop-up saying, hey, do you want to opt into this? Mad people would have said no, but I think 20 million people would have said yes out of 300. You know what I'm saying? Like, probably, enough people would have just clicked yes that you would have gotten this data without having to be grimy. Like, you don't, I hate when, like, people, when they do stuff like this and then we find out later. Like, this is important data that I'm okay with people saying, hey, I want to keep my privacy. I'd rather not be in it. But also some people are going to be like, oh, this is for the greater good. I'll do it. But because you didn't tell us, that's when I start to feel like, oh, you're doing something weird now.
Well, I think the reason they didn't tell us is because they bought the data from elsewhere.
Right.
So it's like, you know, compiled data that they were just like, oh, we're only going to use it for this thing. So, like, we weren't even given a chance because I'm not sure where that data is from and how it was compiled and all kinds of things. So that's like, yikes already. But I mean, we already, that's the other thing is that's kind of on us. Because, you know, we accept all cookies, you know what I mean? And we don't even, you know, allow or don't allow. And we're just like, I don't care, allow. And, you know, like, we don't, we do this. So we're already giving away all this information.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're going to find out about a lot of companies and businesses and entities that have our data in different ways.
Right.
And it's just going to be ugly. But I think what I dislike about this was just like they said they were going to use it for this, but then it comes out that they're also going to, oh, we'll probably also use it for this other general non-COVID thing. And I'm like, what do y'all need to know?
Yeah.
Y'all ain't keeping it together in the home office. Like, you know, like the break room at the CDC is a mess right now. Clean that shit up. Y'all get back to being independent or try to get to being independent from the government so that it's not so obvious what's happening.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, they lost the thread in a few ways during this that it's going to be hard for me to take them seriously because they fucked up so much and continue to do so. And that's kind of wild because they were one of those groups that I would just blindly go, yeah, I mean, what benefits them to lie, you know? So now I guess there is a benefit. I don't know what it is. I mean, people have died and I'm not sure that was the benefit.
Right.
So I don't know what that's about, but I know I don't trust them anymore.
Yeah, I'm done with it. I don't know. I want to trust them again. They got work to do, but.
Yeah. We are like jilted lovers. We're just like, I don't know if I'll ever love again, CDC.
You know what I mean? I need a new combination of three letters. Okay? I need a fresh start, baby. Okay?
Yeah.
I'm done with you. Finally, Tom Brady to join Fox Sports on a lucrative deal as the lead NFL analyst when his playing career ends. Tom Brady will join Fox Sports as his lead NFL analyst once his playing career is over. Fox did not disclose the terms of Brady's deal, but New York Post reported that the seven-time Super Bowl winning champ has agreed to a 10-year, $375 million contract, the most lucrative in sports broadcasting history. We are delighted to that Tom has committed to joining the Fox team and wish him all the best during his up-and-coming season, said Fox CEO Lacaille Murdoch. Brady tweeted that he is excited to eventually join Fox, but noted that he still has unfinished business as a player.
All right. So here's what I'm asking for all football players.
Yeah.
If you could keep Tom Brady from winning this ring, just keep doing it until his body just falls apart. And then he'll never be able to take this job and get that money. I think that's the only way to stop him. Because I don't think he's going to quit until he wins again.
Yeah.
And so if we can, you know, unfix the games. And keep them balls from deflating and keep him from winning. You know, I'm just saying, maybe then we don't have to see him. This is wild. He's never going to leave until he wins. And then he's going to win. And he's like, well, I probably have it in me to win one more. And he just, I don't know if he'll ever properly do this job.
One of this is wild to me. Like, he got a job that he's never done. He's getting paid the most to do the job that he's never done. And he's being told you can start when you want.
Yeah.
Like, none of that sounds real. That is...
No.
Yo.
That's on paper? Is that in the contract?
Yeah.
Let me see that paper.
I want to read the contract. Like, I think this contract is fascinating. Like, I am blown away that, like, this got negotiated. Like, what was... Like, what... Like, when I hear this... All I keep thinking about is, what did he ask for that they settled on this?
Right.
Like, what did he start with? Like, nah, I want half a Billy, and I'm going to do 2 years where I do two games most. I'm going to broadcast from my house and my PJs.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm going to do the whole broadcast over my iPhone on FaceTime. I don't even want your pro mics. Like, how outlandish was, like, his request? They were like, all right. Hold on, B. We got to talk a little bit. That this is what they settled on. How do you settle on this? This is crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, people go to college
to study this.
Work their way up. They do shitty, like, high school games and random, like, off only football high school towns all over the South, hoping to work their way up to get noticed to go to a major city's team broadcast. This dude never done it. Yeah, you get all them racks. Whatever you want, my G, here. Oh, you want to start later? No problem, B.
Yeah, can he speak?
I'm assuming so.
Like, how does he speak, though? Like, is he at all eloquent, or can you tell that he's been possibly hit a few times?
No, he's still solid. But, like, I guess because he's done football, they're assuming that, like, the knowledge that he has of football, he can say that charmingly. Because that's been the cool part of Romo, the Tony Romo, who is doing a similar job at CBS and is another former quarterback. But that's because he's, like, genuinely, like, in love with football. Whereas I think Tom Brady is genuinely in love with Tom Brady.
Ooh, you know, shots fired.
I think it's different. I think he wants to be the dude, and he knows how to talk about himself eloquently for 3 hours, I'm sure. But, like, about, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know if I want to hear his inner thoughts. And, like, I don't know if he's going to deliver that as well. I'm excited. Maybe I'm wrong. He is super competitive. He's won. But I don't know. Like, I feel like Tony Romo has loved football, and it shows in his broadcasting. I think Tom Brady loves winning more than he loves football. And I think that's going to come off different when he's no longer the one winning.
Mm. Yeah, because that's the thing is, I feel like he won't – once if he does start to win with this return, I feel like he'll just keep going until he literally disintegrates. Because
– yeah.
I mean, well, I come out of a retirement to try and win one more time. It's unnecessary.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Boy. Avocado ice cream is not going to hold that dude together at some point.
No.
Like, you're going to fall apart, my G.
You know what I mean? You should just go on and let it happen and start the rebuild.
Serious. For your safety. But no, he keeps going out there. He's trying. He might die one of these years. I hope it doesn't happen. You know, I really do. But by the same token, I don't want to see this dude broadcasting. I don't care for it. You know?
Yeah, but, I imagine it's just going to be him seeing something and going, well, you know, when I did this, blah, 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 blah. Or if that was me out there, I'd yada, yada, yada. And it's like, no one cares.
Exactly. Like, real talk. Okay. I love watching Michael Jordan play. And I would love to hear him analyze one game. But, like, if he was the analyst for a season, That would be nuts. I wouldn't want to watch those games. You're like, oh, I would have made that shot. Oh, I would have made that shot too.
Right,
you know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, I don't need that for 3 hours, my G. That's not analyzing. That's what I think Tom Brady's going to do. Yep, I'd have made that pass. I'd have made that pass. See the way he did that? I'd have done that better. You know?
You're absolutely right. It's bananas. Yeah, no one should have to sit through that.
Yeah, yo. Come on, y'all. Like, I don't know. But Fox, you know, if you got bread like that, holla at us. Be like, Shalay, well, now we can learn football.
Yeah, I'll pick up something.
You know?
I can talk about the halftime.
Here we go. Better than anybody has ever talked about the halftime.
Yeah, okay? Absolutely.
If you would like for Fox to hire me and Shalay to be the new sportscasting duo, or maybe not football, for random other sports, we can learn the sports together as a country. Admittedly, football is a high bar, okay? I'm not crazy. You know?
Okay, so what, like Australian rules football
there we
or
go.
Rugby? Or
we going to do rugby, badminton. Cricket, badminton.
We gonna no, I ain't jumping into cricket. Yo, cricket is something serious.
We could do one of those weird games that like nobody knows all the rules to, like that volleyball that they play with a volleyball, but it's still off of a ping pong table. Like that. We could do stuff like that.
Wow, yeah, okay.
Real niche, yeah. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, we could do like we could be the announcers for tag, you know, where they got like
okay,
those obstacle
I'll
courses.
Do that, yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So yeah,
okay.
Fox, hit us up. You know, if you would like for us to be hired by Fox for this very exclusive niche, admittedly only like twice a year broadcast job.
Same pay though.
Same pay. Even if it's just per game, I'm okay. You know.
Yeah.
I'll take that hit. You know. All you got to do is like, subscribe to the show, baby. If you are an Apple or Spotify listener, we appreciate your rating sincerely. 4 stars means you don't think Shinnok can master the nuances of table volleyball. You haven't seen us, okay? You don't know our study game. Did you see the notes that Shalay would take before every one of these episodes? Because they don't exist. They're in her head, but she's ready, okay?
Yeah. I'm ready. I'm absolutely
you know,
ready.
I'm ready too, despite the fact that I pick all these articles half hour before every episode. Okay? Real work, baby.
Yeah.
5 stars. You see the genius. You know what we're capable of. We're just slackers, but we haven't been motivated by $375 million to do real work. Okay?
Yeah, that'll do it.
That'll do it. I'll study for that. 100%. You know, if you got any articles you'd like us to cover, DM us directly on Twitter or Instagram at Silky Jumbo or at Gastromonte. Shout outs to the homie Will Cat for sending in a couple articles this week. Appreciate you, homie. With all that said, I am future broadcasting legend, Gastromonte. Always with the also future broadcasting legend. Similar to like John Madden, Shalay will only travels in a tour bus. Shalay was sharp. You know?
Just me and the cat. In the
tour bus. Over to the tour bus traveling, Shalay with Sharp. This has been a War Report. Catch y'all next time. Peace.